Hey, what is up everyone? Norman from Future Student University here, and welcome to our fourth video in our Glide series. Now, so far we have only looked at images. So we've loaded images, you have used placeholders, and you've resized them. But Glide is really unique in also offering all of that to GIFs. Now, the GIF handling is a little bit different, but it's completely out of the box for Glide, and that's really, really awesome. So in this video, we will look at some particular things for GIFs. And as always, you can find the tutorial, so if you want to read stuff, on our website. It's the first link in the description below, and the code is on GitHub. I think let's jump in. I'm back in our project, in our main activity. I've prepared a load image GIF method. It probably should be load GIF and not load image GIF. But anyway, so far we have looked up URLs. So I'm going to change this and load GIF. Now I'm going to use a local GIF, so I've added a GIF to our project here. But theoretically, that could also be an internet URL. It doesn't matter if it's a local GIF or internet GIF, it will display it either way. It's just a pretty big GIF, so it's faster if it's local. And this is under the drawable and funny. Now I'm going to remove this for now and start this. And as you can see, it's displaying the GIF and it has some animals dance, which is kind of funny. But as you can see, the call is the exact same. You don't have to do any special GIF handling. Glide will automatically recognize, okay, this is a GIF, so I'm going to display it as a GIF. You can still apply everything else, so the arrow callbacks and transformation we will look at later, all of that works exactly the same for GIFs. And if you want to make sure that what you're loading is actually GIF, so maybe you have an app where you load dynamic URLs and you have a GIF display and you want to make sure that is actually a GIF, you can make sure by calling sGIF. So what's happening if this is not a GIF, so let me change this to our photo URL. No, I'm loading a photo, but I said I want a GIF. So what's happening is it will fall back to the error. It will say, yes, you loaded something that is a valid resource, but you said you expected a GIF. This is not a GIF. So I'm going to display the error placeholder. And as you can see, it will fall back to the error placeholder. If you don't know the error placeholder stuff yet, we have a video on that as well. So feel free to watch it. Of course, this also works the other way. So you can say, I want this as a bitmap. And the difference is if you load a GIF and say I'm expecting a bitmap, it will not fall back to the error. It will say, okay, we have a GIF. We can make a bitmap out of this by just displaying the first frame. So if we do it this way, we are loading a GIF, we are saying we expect a bitmap, Glide will not throw an error, we'll just say here is the first frame of that GIF, but I will not play it. And there you go, it will just display the first frame. There's one more feature I like to mention with Glide, and that is showing the thumbnail of a local video. So if your app contains videos, or maybe you load images on the file system, you can use Glide to show the first frame of that video. And it's, again, really easy. So down here you have our regular call, and you're loading a video file on the file system. And the nice thing about Glide is you can just use the regular calls and it will simply show the thumbnail of that video. And if I scroll down a little bit, you will see that video file is actually the source for our GIF, and it will only display the thumbnail, not the full video. If you want to display like the full video, then you probably want to use the video view from the Android system for that. That's it for this video. Like this video if you thought the GIF was funny, and subscribe for more upcoming Glide videos. Enjoy coding and make it rock!